taking on Morristown, who eliminated Bloomfield last weekend in the morning match. Bar Reef rolled into the semifinals without losing a game, and all the Bar Reef faithful were on hand to lend their support. And loud the voices to Amber Gwynn and the Lady Vikings for the simple task of win two and become state champion. And in the semifinal match, the Lady Vikings used a third set service ace from Jennifer Wirtz to defeat Morristown 15-2, 7-15, 15-8 to advance to the state championship game against the two-time defending champion Michigan City Marquette. As Greta Gingrich passes up Shayna Jones, who back sets to Jennifer Wirtz for the kill, but even with 110% effort given out by the Lady Vikings, Michigan City was too tough. But the Bar Reeve Lady Vikings have nothing to be ashamed of as they surpass all expectations and walk away with the runner-up trophy.
We played with all we had and a lot of heart, and we have nothing to hang our heads about. We're very proud of our accomplishments this year.
I like how we got to play two games. We made it more exciting and kind of more, I don't know, really. The competition is just unbelievable. And like Amber said, we're just happy to get the opportunity.
See, a lot of people from Davis County came over to us. Kind of make you guys feel really good to have back
here.
Yeah,
pretty much our whole town. Yeah. So we were very excited. And our crowd usually never gets into it, never stands up. And when they stand up, you know they're into it. So it was great.
The pump is up, and we're really glad.
As one...
Thank you. Thank you.
Starting out with Morristown, we come out ready to go, fired up, and we played very well the first game, looked sluggish the second game, and then finished focused. Going against Marquette, very, very talented, and we are so honored that we got to play against them. We played with all we had and a lot of heart, and we have nothing to hang our heads about. We're very proud of our accomplishment this year. Yes. When they have a six-footer going out, they had another one coming in. So it was...
Did it surprise a lot of you guys? Shots that normally would have been in against Bloomfield or somebody else.
You know, obviously their blockers took a lot away from us, and we tried to adjust our hits, and they were still getting touches and pieces of hand on them. So it was frustrating for our hitters. I thought our serve reception passing was good for the most part during Marquette, but whenever our blockers are struggling getting pieces of things, then obviously that's going to cause trouble for our back row.
How difficult was it to try to do something that's not provided? I don't know what the vertical is, but it seems to be out of the blocks.
them.
Girl,
that one you were. I don't think there was any blocker that was going to stop five. You know, like you said, her vertical is just amazing, and we tried to take away angle, she would go line, then we would try to take away line, and then she would just go over us. You know, that's just something where you just have to say that's a great hitter, give the hitter credit, and move on to the next play. Seven are turning and losing five. These five behind me, yes.
Can I ask Courtney a question?
Sure.
Courtney, you were here 4 years ago. 4 years
ago. Oh, well, last time I was in the stands. I practiced with the team, but I didn't get to play. I liked how we got to play 2 games. It made it more exciting and kind of more, I don't know, really. The competition is just unbelievable. And like Amber said, we're just happy to get the opportunity.
About being a senior and kind of in it this way. I mean, obviously on a state level and a championship game, it's got to be really exciting.
We're all of us seniors are like so close, and it's an honor to even be here. And yes, we wanted first place, but second place is tremendous. I mean, the excitement and everything, words can't even describe how happy we are. We're sad, but the reason why we were crying is because our season's over. And we love it so much, we don't want it to end.
What do you think is your first year?
Hey, it's just a great feeling, and it's a great atmosphere for the girls, you know, being at Hinkle and playing against such great, great competition. And, you know, I know the girls enjoyed the weekend, and the whole tournament was just outstanding for them. We're definitely staying to watch Mitchell and Burris.
We need the crowd support tonight. I mean, today, obviously, a lot of people from Davis County came up the road. It's got to be, guys, feel real good to have backers like that.
It's pretty much our whole town. Yeah, we are. So we're very excited. And our crowd usually never gets into it, never stands up. And when they stand up, you know they're into it. So it was great.
I'm just up. I'm really glad.
Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
Michigan City Marquette with the winner over Cowan, and they advance in three games. So Marquette will serve first. Barry will be on defense. There's a whistle, and we're underway. They get it over to Barry. Barry will bump it up front, and she tips it over. Now Michigan City keeps it alive. Now they get up for the spike, and they got it. So point number one for Michigan City as a spike there. So again, Laura Moore will serve it to Barry. Barry will bump it up front, set it up for Wirth, and Wirth gets a kill. So side out for Barry. Serving for Barry will be Allison Ash. Substitution will be Allison Miller in for Barry. Greta Ginrick out. Allison Ash serving. Michigan City up 1-0. Barry serves it to Michigan City. They set it up, and Barry tries to keep it alive, but can't do it. It goes off the hands of one of the players out of bounds, so side out for Michigan City. Now number seven coming in, Savetic, up there in front. Tall girl up front, now serving the number three, Zedeb. Now they serve long out of bounds, so side out for Barry. Michigan City leading 1-0 over Barreve in this championship game in Class 1A volleyball. Abby Rademacher serving for Barreve, and she serves it out of bounds as it goes across court and out of bounds. So another substitution coming in will be number two, Pauline Hassel. Yes, will come in now. Serving will be number six, Leslie Paz. Now they get it over to Barreve. Barreve will set it up for Wirtz. Wirtz gets the spike. No side out for Barry. All right, Wirtz moves to the back row. She serves for Barry. And a service there for Barry as it goes into the net. So a turnover. And it goes back Michigan City, and they will serve. Kelly Cochran. She serves it to Barry. Barry will set it up front. To Old with it, and Michigan City keeps it going. Now they bring it back, and they drop it in right between two players. So a point for Michigan City as they go up 2-0. Again, Cochran serving for Michigan City. They serve it across to Barreve, and out of bounds, long on the serve. And there have been, three service errors, two for Michigan City and one for Barreve, and surprising in a championship game. In.
I think everybody's pumped up.
All right, Greta Ginrick in for Barreve. She will be serving. Also in is Christian Warrick. Now over to Michigan City. Michigan City sets it up and tipped, and Barreve now setting it up on the other side. Greta Graber sets it up over to Michigan City, and they try to spike, and they get it. So Larimore side out for Michigan City. And again, substitution for Michigan City. So, Maku Dzinski coming. She gets it across. And off the hand of one of the Barre players, and a point for Michigan City. So they go up 3-0. And Barre can ill afford to get down to Michigan City. Now again, across. Barry sets it up front. Now they go to Olds, who tips it across, trying to go across, is blocked back. So another point for Michigan City. So 4-0, Michigan City on top here in this early going to the championship game. They get it across. Barry up front. Oh, they block it back. Now tip back and forth. Now Michigan City with it. And side out for Barreve as it went back and off the fingertips. Number six, Leslie Pauls. And so side out for Barreve. Back into the ballgame is Alyssa Graver for Barreve. Out is Abby Rademacher. Kendra Graver serving for Barreve. She'll get it across. Now Michigan City getting it set up. Now they'll bump it across to Barreve. Barreve will set it up. Now side out as on the spike went out of bounds. Wari spiked it out of bounds, so it'll be Michigan City's serving. Michigan City up 4-0. Elizabeth Chicaney serving. They already lead 4-0. Barreve now takes it up front. Now Oles with it, and she got the kill. So side out for Barreve.
6 points on the board.
Courtney Old serving for Barreve. She'll get it across. Now Michigan City sets it up. And a kill there by Michigan City as they got two to the net at one time. Not sure who got that kill, but boy, they both go up the same time. All right, serving is Larimore again for Michigan City. Now Barreve will take it up front. And trying to take it over the net, couldn't do it, so a point for Michigan City, 5-0. Michigan City out front. Now they get it across. And another point for Michigan City. A timeout going to be called by Barreve. Michigan City out to a 6-0 lead here in the championship game. We'll be right back. Okay, welcome back here to Butler Fieldhouse. Again, Michigan City serving. It'll be Larimore. Now over to Barreve. They'll set it up. That'll work. She attempts a spike, and she got it on the back. So a spike for Barreve. Side out for Barreve. Now substitutions. Ash and Miller in for Barreve. Out is Genrich and Wari. So Allison Ash will serve. Barreve trails 6-0. Ash gets it across for Barreve. Michigan City sets it up. And they tip it across, and not a spike, but they just tipped it across, and a side out for Michigan City. So
Michigan City that time did do what they did for them.
Number three, Zadeb serving for Michigan City. They get it across. Now Barreve will set it up front for Wirtz, and she got the kill. Wirtz with the kill, so side out for Barreve. Abby Rademacher getting ready to come in for Barreve. Out is Alicia Graber. Over to Michigan City. Now Michigan City sets it up again and blocked out of bounds. So side out for Michigan City. As she is about, what, 6'1", looks like. Yeah. All right, serving number six, Paz, as she serves long out of bounds. And that is the third error for service error for Michigan City. Now. Work serving for Barreve. She gets it across. Now Michigan City. Ball tipped and they get a carry. So a point for Barreve. So 6-1. Now again, work serving. She'll get it across. Now they go trying to go up front and tip there, and Barreve trying to keep it alive. And now Michigan City keeps it alive. Now they go for the kill. Barreve keeps it going. Over to Old and over to Michigan City. Now they try to set it up. There's a tempered spike and out of bounds, they said. And it was a delayed call. And so a point for Barreve, I presume. 6-2. Again, word serving. She'll get it across and out of bounds. So on the other side, so side out for Michigan City. So serving will be Cochran, Kelly Cochran for Michigan City. She'll get it across. Now Barry trying to get it up front. Now Old gets it across to, now Michigan City sets up for the kill and off the hand of the Barre player. So 7-2, point for Michigan City. Again, Kelly Cochran serving for Michigan City. She'll get it across. Now back to across to Michigan City, but they said an illegal hit. They boost the ball, so side out for Barre. Greta Ginrich serving for Barre. She'll get it across. Now Michigan City sitting, and a kill there by number 7. Samantha Savetic. At, she goes high above the net, so side out for Michigan City. Number 32 into the ball game, Colleen Wall. Now serving as number 2, Paulette Hassel. And now Barre in the backcourt, and they do get it across. Now Michigan City setting it up and blocked there, and now they say someone was in the net for Barre, so a point for Michigan City, 8-2. Again, Michigan City serving. Hassel, she gets it across. Barre trying to set it up. Old and blocked. And again, back on Barre's side, unable to get it back across. So 9-2. And a timeout going to be called by Barre with Michigan City up 9-2. We'll be back after this. Okay, welcome back here at Butler Fieldhouse. Again, Michigan City with a 9-2 lead, and they are serving. It's Mac Lazinski serving. They get it over to Barre. Now Barre takes it up front, and a spike there by Oles. Side out for Barre. High Kinder Graver will serve for Barre. They trail 2-9. Now they get it across. Michigan City getting it set up. And attempted kill. Now Barre gets it back up front and now unable to get it across. So side out for Michigan City. And a substitution. Number 10 into the ball game, Elizabeth Chicaney. She will serve. Michigan City. It in for Barre. Now they get it across. Now Barre having a little trouble. Now they get it across to Michigan City. Michigan City sets up again, and Barre keeps it going, but no, out of bounds. So a point for Michigan City. 10-2. Makudazinski, Aneta Makudazinski, serving for Michigan City. They're up 10-2 in this first game of the championship game here. Get it across. Now Barre trying to get it set up. Now off the arm of one of the Michigan City. That was Hyatt that got the kill for Barre. Kendra Hyatt for Barre. Now Oles will be serving for Barre. She'll get it across. Now Michigan City blocked. Now back across to Michigan City. And now Michigan City gets it back across. I tell you what, side out for Michigan City is they're all over the court. A well-oiled machine. Now Larimore serving for Michigan City. They get it across. Now Barre is setting it up front to Wirtz and blocked out of bounds. So side out Barre on the spike there by Wirtz. So substitution for Barre, Ash and Miller in, and Wari and Ginrich out. Allison Ash will serve. She'll get it across. Now Now Barry keeps it going on the other side, and no, by a miscommunication there, so side out for Michigan City as they got it up close to the net. And All right, serving now number three, Zadeb. Now on Barry's side, they set it up for Wirtz. Wirtz with attempted kill and off the fingertips. So side out for Barry. Abby Rademacher coming in the ball game. Kendra Hyde out. They trail 2-10. Now across to Michigan City. Michigan City getting ready to set up. And block back to Michigan City. Now they block it back, and unable to get it back across is number five, Cochran. So a point for Barry. 10-3. Now Abby Rademacher serving again. Over to Michigan City. They set it up, and the kill blocked back to Michigan City. And they set it up again and tipped back to Barry. And Barry gets it across to Michigan City. Now again, they set it up, and oh my, number seven, Savetic with a powering kill. So, number six, Haas serving for Michigan City. They set it up front. Now Wirtz on the other, kill for Wirtz, as it was blocked off the arm of a Michigan City player. So side out for Barry. Wirtz will be serving. 3-10, Barry behind here in this first game. They get it across to Michigan City. They set it up and out of bounds. Michigan City serves it out of bounds. So a point for Barry, 10-4. Again, Wirtz will serve for Barry. She'll get it across to Michigan City. They'll set it up. And tip there, and all right, no man's land where nobody was, so side out for Michigan City. All right, now Michigan City serving. Now Barry, they try to get it up close, and Oles gets it across to Michigan City. Now Michigan City tips it back. Now they set it up for Oles again. Off her fingertips, so a side out for Barry. So Courtney Oles is out height considerably, but hey, she gets up and still continues to pound at the net. Barry trails 4-10. Greta Genrich in to serve now for Barry. She'll get it across. Now Michigan City keeping it going. Now they get it across to Barry. Barry will set it up. Oles with it, blocked back. There again, number seven, I believe, there's two of them up there. Savetic was one. I'm not sure who the other one was, but side out for Michigan City. Michigan City leads 10-4 here in this championship game of the Class 1A State Volleyball Championship. All right, they get it across to Barry. Now Barry will set it up, and over to Michigan City. They try to get it back across. Now over to Barry. They'll set it up. And Oles now blocked back. As she tried to spike it, it was blocked back to Barry. So a point for Michigan City. 11-4. And it is Makanazinski who will be serving. Number 22. I can only see the two. Yeah, you're right, Mike. All right. Over to Michigan City. And blocked at the net. Still on Barry's side, but back to, they get it over to Michigan City. Now Michigan City trying to take it back, and Barry keeping alive on their side. Oles with it, and she tries to dump it in, but Michigan City keeps it going. Now back to Barry's side. Barry setting it up for Oles, and blocked back and back. But they say it, I'm not the, Oles in the net, so a point for Michigan City. 12-4. Again, Michigan City serves. They set it up for Oles. And a spike by Oles, and she hammered that one down. So side out for Barry. Barrie battling here, but they're battling a big giant in the girls' volleyball, Michigan City Marquette. Kendra Braver sets it across to Michigan City. They set it up and block back, as so a point for Barrie. So 12-5. Blocked at the net. Timeout going to be called by Michigan City. Barrie trailing here, 12-5. We'll be back after this. Okay, welcome back here to Butler Fieldhouse. Louis Cavanaugh, along with Mike Strawn, for the Class 1A state championship game. Michigan City Marquette up over Barrie at this point, 12-5. Kendra Graver serving for Barrie. Michigan City setting it up, and the attempted spike is by Michigan City. So side out for Michigan City. Again, substitutions. Number 10 coming in to serve, Chicaney. Chicaney serving for Michigan City Marquette. 34-4. Over to Barrie. They're trying to set it up front. Barrie tipped it down, and Michigan City kept it going. Now over to Barrie, and they said an illegal hit on Michigan City, so side out for Barrie. By Courtney Ohl serving. She'll get it across, and long out of bounds. So side out for Michigan City. Number one, Laura Larimore serving for Michigan City. She'll get it across. Barrie now setting it up for Wirtz, and tipped a kill there. I guess you could call it anything you want. Wirtz just tipped the ball, and it was almost in midair. They were both tapping the ball at the same time, and finally fell off on the Michigan City side. So a side out for Barrie. Allison Ash comes in to serve. She'll get it across to Michigan City. Michigan City sets it up, and the attempted spike is good by Michigan City. Number five with it, Kelly Cochran. And on these stats, there's several for Michigan City that have a long list of kills, led there by Kelly Cochran, 323. All right, serving is Michigan City, and they serve it out of bounds. So number 32, I think, Kelly Wall, Colleen Wall served it long. Unusual service errors here. Now Abby Rademacher serves for Barrie. Over to Michigan City. And they tipped it, but Barrie trying to keep it going, can't do it, but side out for Michigan City. This game has went back. Been Michigan City leading from the beginning, but Barrie has stayed in there. Now Kendra Graver trying to get it across into the net, so a point for Michigan City, 13-5. All right, serving is number six, Leslie Paz for Michigan City. She'll get it across. Now Barrie will tip it up. And now good job there by Kendra Graver. She tipped it right across off the fingertips and out of bounds of one of the players, number 10 of Michigan City. So Jennifer Wirtz will serve for Barrie. 13-5, Michigan City up. And here they go. And wow, kill there by by Cochran. As the ball is going up and it's just right above the net, that's when she powders it, I guess, and it comes through. Oh, it is. And now Cochran will serve. And out of bounds. A long serve, so side out for Barrie. And it'll be Greta Genrich serving. Now over to Michigan City, and they go for the kill. Block. Barrie keeps it going. They take it up front, and Kendra Graver knocks it across to Michigan City. Now the kill. Barrie keeps it going. Now back, and they get it across. Now Michigan City, they set it up, and they get the kill. Michigan City now 14-5.
Every time Michigan sets the ball.
I take that back. That was not, that wasn't a point, so side out. Now they set it up for Olds, and over to Michigan City. They're trying to keep it going, and back to Barrie. They try to keep it going. Kendra Graber gets it across to Michigan City, back to them, and they bump it across to Barrie. Now Barrie will try to set it up for Olds. She'll tip it across to Michigan City. Michigan City, they go for the kill, block back. Nice block there by Courtney Olds. So side out for Barrie. I was thinking that they were serving a while ago, but that was not when I gave them that point. So it is, score is 13-5, Michigan City on top. Kendra Graber serving. Michigan City sets it up, blocked back, but out of bounds. Barrie blocked it back and out of bounds, so side out to Michigan City. This game has really taken a while, Mike. So now it'll be number 10, Chicaney, Elizabeth Chicaney, serving for Michigan City. They lead 13-4. They get it across. Now Barrie will try to set it up front. Now Olds with it, and she got the back line, so a kill on the back line, so side out for Barrie. Michigan City very powerful, but I tell you what, Barrie not going easy. Courtney Olds will serve. Now they get it across to Michigan City. Now they set it up, and a kill there by, sure that was number 32, was that Wall? Oh, my. So, again, they do not let the ball get way up there before they come down on it. All right, 13-5, Michigan City. Now, number one, Larimore, serving. Now, ball's tipped and a point for Michigan City. So, 14-5 as we go for game point here. Larimore will go for game point. They get it across. Now, Barrie takes it up front. And now into the net. So that is game point for Michigan City as they win this first game here, 15-5 over Barrie. And we'll take a timeout with the team switch sides and move back for game number two. Surprisingly, there were several service errors that you don't see. Of course, Michigan City with long serves, not into the net, but long serves. But all right, Courtney Olds was started off for Barrie. She will serve first. Line up pretty well the same. In the front row for Barrie is Wirtz, Alyssa Graber, and Allison Ash. Back row is Kendra Graber and Courtney Olds. Now the spike by, as they started, Kelly Cochran with a spike, so a side out for Michigan City.
Kelly Cochran come all the way over.
All right, now Barrie setting it up on their side. Now they get it across. Now Michigan City setting it up. And Barrie trying to keep it going, and they do get it across. A good save. They set it up and block back to Michigan City, but they keep it going. Again, now Barrie's trying to keep it going on their side. Again, over to Michigan City. And, oh, my. Was that number six, I believe, for Michigan City? Pause that just went up and got and took the ball and just dunked it almost. So a point for Michigan City as they lead here 1-0. Now long serve out of bounds. That was number three, Rachel Sadeb, so side out for Barrie. They trail 1-0 here in the second game. First game won here by Michigan City. Now Allison Ash serves for Barrie. Get over to Michigan. Now ball knocked back and forth to Michigan City. Now back to Barrie, back to Michigan City. And then again, number five, dumping the ball right on the line, Kelly Cochran, so side out for Michigan City. Now, Mike, is that considered a kill? As good as. All right, serving is number six, Leslie Paul, over to Barrie. They try to set it up for Wirtz, and she got the kill. Wirtz with the kill. So substitution for Barrie, Abby Rademacher in, Alicia Graver out. Barrie trails 1-0 here in this championship class 1A game here from Butler Fieldhouse. Over to Michigan City. Now they set it up and the spike. Now Barrie try to keep it going and they do. They get it across. Again, Michigan City sets it up and oh, kill there by Michigan City. I think that was number two, Hassel, I think. So side out for Michigan City. Number five, Kelly Cochran will serve. She gets it across. Now Barrie with it over to Michigan City and now attempted kill. Barrie keeps it going. Now over to Michigan City. They set it up and ball's tipped and now it's tipped back over to Michigan City. Now again, the Michigan City will dump it across. Barrie will set it up for Wirtz and over to Michigan City. And Barrie wanted a carry on that but didn't get it. Now again, Wirtz will over to Michigan City. They dig it out and the kill blocked back to Michigan City and an illegal hit. So Barrie does get the side out that time. Wow, what a volley. So Jennifer Wirtz will be serving. She'll get it across to, now they set it up and blocked back and into the net. So a point for Barrie. Serving. She'll get it across. Now they set it up and block back a kill, I guess. It went across, but side out for Michigan City. So substitutions for Michigan City, number 22 coming in. Makunizinski. All right, she'll get it across. Barrie now trying to set it up. And Oles blocked back. And they set a carry on. So a point for Michigan City. They go up 2-1 over Barrie. Again, out of bounds. Long serve by Makunizinski. And so it'll be Barrie's side out. Greta Genrich will serve.
That's got to be tearing Michigan City coach up because every time they keep the ball in play, they always think they score. They have really given away, so side out.
Barrie over to Michigan City. Now the attempted spike off the hand of Barrie players, so a side out for Michigan City. Barrie can't seem to get a run. So a substitution into the ballgame, number 10, Elizabeth Sakani. She gets ready to serve. She'll get it across. Now, off the end of the hand of one of the Barrie players, so a point for Michigan City. 3-1. Michigan City up 3-1 in this second game. Again, Michigan City out of bounds, long on the serve. So, and now Kendra Graver will serve for Barrie. She'll get it across. Now Michigan City trying to get it set up and oh my. Number 32. As they go part way up and they come down with a kill. So side out to Michigan City. Laura Moore will serve. She'll get it across. Now Barrie trying to get it set up. Over to Michigan City. Now Michigan City will set it up. And oh my. Number five with a kill, Kelly Cochran, and set perfectly, and she come down on it. So a point for Michigan City, 4-1. Now across to Barrie. They set it up. Now to Oles with it, over to Michigan City. Now again, they set it up and block back to, again, they try it, and Oles off the fingertips out of bounds, so another point for Michigan City, 5-1. So, awesome display here. heard Michigan City could just about play in any class. And off the fingertips of a Barre player, so 6-1. Another point. Timeout going to be called by Barre. In the second game here, Michigan City opened up a 6-1 lead. We'll be back after this. We're in the championship game here. Michigan City's already won the first one 15-5. They lead 6-1 in the second game. And Barre battling, but tell you what, Michigan City just a real powerhouse here in Class 1A, going for their third championship. Now Michigan City gets it across to Barre, trying to set it up. And again, they set it up too close to the net, and a spike by Michigan City, so 7-1. Again, serving number one, Laura Moore. She'll get it across. Now, Barre trying to get it set up and block back. Now back to Michigan City. And again, they go up with it. And Barre trying to keep it going, but it's going to be out of play. So another point for Michigan City. Just an awesome display as they just come to the net. And Walls, especially over here, number five, or Kelly Cochran. Now they get it across. Barre bumps it up front. Now again, they get it too close to the net, and a kill by Paz, I believe it was. So 9-1, and I'm sure Amber is like, what do you do? So again, yes. All right, Michigan City serving to Barre. Again, back to Michigan City. Again, set up to Michigan City with the block out of bounds. Point for Michigan City. Off the fingertips of Barre, so 10-1. Now they get it across. Barre will try to set it up. Not the holes, and she gets it. Now Michigan City will set it up, and Cochran. Now Barre will set it up. Holes. Off the fingertip, Michigan City keeps it going, but can't quite do it, so side out for Barre. But body's laying all over the floor, trying to dig it out. Barre giving it the old college try, they say, but it's...
Barre expanded a lot of energy just to get a side out. That's what's tough.
And they have played the second game today, and I'm sure a very emotional game. And here they got to come back in about 2 hours to play this championship game. A little bit more rest, but now over to Michigan City. Now here goes the kill, and again, number five, Cochran. Goes in the air, and it doesn't go back. It goes down, straight down. So side out for Michigan City. Again, coming in to serve will be number 21. A little bit, somebody new. No, that's not. Shakarney. Oh, no, wait a minute. That's number 21. All right. A point for Michigan City is off the fingertips of Barre player. So 11-1. All right. Sicani. Again, she'll get it across. Barre trying to get it up front. Again, they'll have to bump it across. Now Michigan City setting it up. And blocked back to them by Barre. Now setting up again for Cochran. And blocked, and she does. She gets the point. It goes out of bounds off the Barre player. 12-1. Timeout going to be called by Barre. Michigan City up 12-1 in this second game. And we'll be back right after this. In this championship game, it's been all Michigan City as they now lead 12-1. They've won the first game. Doesn't look too good for Barre at this point. Mary Shikaney, she'll get it across to Barre. Now Barre setting it up to Wirtz. Wirtz blocked back to a point for Michigan City, 13-1. Bound to be disheartening as the old momentum goes, and they now into the ball game. Some new players, Teresa Osborne and Jen Meyer. Some names, Mike, we could pronounce. Across to Barre. Barre setting it up for Wirtz and blocked back and out of bounds, so side out from Barre. So into the ball game will be Ash and Miller. Out will be Ginrich and Wire. Ash, how Allison Ash, a junior. Barreve's got some nucleus here, some underclassmen, across to Michigan City. Michigan City setting it up for Cochran. Again, a kill by Cochran. So, side out for Michigan City. Number six, Leslie Pauls, will serve. Serves it across to Barreve. They set it up front, setting it up for spike by Wirtz as it goes off the player. I think it might have been out of bounds. They let it gone, but yeah. Also into the ball game, Shea Jones for Barreve serving. She'll get it across. Now Michigan City setting it up and blocked back to Michigan City by Barreve. And they dump it across to Barreve. Now Barreve gets it up front, setting it up, and trying to go across, couldn't do it. So a side out for Michigan City. They lead 13-1, and serving will be number five, Kelly Cochran, who's been a little bit of everything here today. They get it across to Barreve. Barreve, Shea Jones sets it up. Wirtz. Wirtz got the corner, so a side out for Barreve. And Wirtz will move to the back row to serve. Barreve lost the first game 15-5. They trail here 13-1. Wirtz gets it across to now set up for the spike and out of bounds. So off the Barreve player, so side out for Michigan City. They don't bump it across very often. Michigan City is always set up for one of those killer spikes. Now Barreve setting it up for Oles. Over to Michigan City. Again, they set it up. And the attempted spike goes long out of bounds by Michigan City, so side out for Barreve. All right, so into the ball game, Greta Ginrich will serve. Ginrich, Greta Ginrich, the senior, and into the net, a service error. So when things go wrong, but I tell you what, in spite of how things go, Mike, you can't take away from the excellent season that they've, the Barreve girls have had. Also a new girl for, number two, Hassel. All right, over to Barreve. Now Barreve setting it up for Oles. Over to Michigan City now. And a spike there by number one, Lorimore. So point for Michigan City now. We come up on game point, 14-1, Michigan City, game point. Over to Barreve. Barreve will bump it up front with the Oles. And long on the spike, and that's it. Barreve loses here as Michigan City Marquette, the Blazers, win their third state Class 1A girls volleyball championship, their third 1A class volleyball championship in a row. We're going to take...
Head coach, Amber Grant. Assistant coach.